Good afternoon. Sometimes it's a good thing to speak towards the end. Most people are probably getting ready for lunch, and almost everything I wanted to say has already been said. So I'm going to be pretty short and take you through some thoughts that we have on what we think are relevant information and thoughts on what schools will be or should be going forward. I wanted to take you through the last 5 to 10 years and tell you what has happened to society. Everything from how we travel, what we use, what we see around us, the technology we use today, everything has changed. The rate of change in the last 10 years is so fast that it is far outstripped the change in the last 50 years of our life. And the rate of change in the next 10 years is expected to double what has already changed in the last 5 years. If you look at the numbers, they are staggering. I remember way back when I was a kid, the three greatest things that a man in India could own was a telephone connection, a gas connection, and if you got really lucky, a Bajaj Chetak scooter. If he had that, he was set for life. And today, when you look around, who cares about a telephone? Everybody has a cell phone. Who cares about laptops? I worked in the IT industry for many years. And it used to be very fashionable a few years ago to hang around with a laptop. Today, it's a pain. You get spondylosis. Laptop prices are collapsing. And when we look at all of these things, you will find that we often say education in schools and that realm of academia doesn't change. It's slow to change. But well, change is being forced on them. They might not exactly be coming in happily laughing, at least they're not kicking and screaming as they come in. Technology has invaded all aspects of our life. And it's very happy to note the government is thinking very proactively in the way they want to use technology in the classroom. I keep on hearing Kapil Sibal talk about all kinds of new things that he wants to talk about, a tablet PC which costs less than XYZ, and so on. And like quite a few speakers have talked about, majorly in terms of academics, being supplanted with what we learn, life skills, employability skills, and so on. I'd like to talk about only three areas that we believe that would impact schools in the future and learners in the future: technology, parenting, and market demands. When we talk about technology, laptops used to cost a lakh of rupees about 5 years ago. They cost about 20,000-30,000 rupees now. Another 5 years, less than 10,000 rupees. So it's not very difficult to imagine children toting laptops to school. Storage devices, I come from the mainframe era. We had storage devices which ran for a few rooms in the floor or sometimes even a whole floor. Storage devices of a terabyte are today available on a small stick. You can just plug it in anywhere you want. Internet access was a luxury. Today it's available anywhere. You sit in this room, you can be surfing while I'm speaking. It's available on your phone. I don't even know if you're looking at your phone to speak to someone. Very few people, I think, today speak on the phone. People use it to surf the net, message people. All this is resulting in learners having a vast array of technology available to them, learners having access to immense amount of information. It's now a problem of plenty. What information should learners have? Whether it's the right information, how do we validate that information? Learners are also becoming members of mushrooming social networking sites. Everybody is a member of something or the other. And television is all pervasive. Governments today give away television to everybody. Whether you have electricity or not, you get a television. Governments today insist on giving you television. And the kind of things that you can now get on a cell phone is amazing. The lesser the better. When you look at technology in the future, we watch television, we watch movies. Today television does not yet have 3D in the home, but tomorrow it will have 3D at the home. We will have 3D internet browsing. We will have video chat with multi-participants. And everything will converge into a single device. You won't have a laptop and a TV and a device to speak. It will all become one device. Today there is more and more technology involved in gaming and using gaming for learning. I can go on. There's so much happening. I don't want to kill you with this. One aspect which I personally would like to speak about is the concept of parenting and how it is shifting. We often tend to gloss over this, but this is a very, very important aspect of what is happening in schools. I was speaking to Dr. Alka, and this issue is not just about urban schools, but it happens in rural schools as well. Parenting is a big issue. In urban schools, parents are dual income, parents have a lot many things to do, malls to visit, TV to watch, jobs to do. So they don't want the parenting experience anymore. They want less and less of the parenting. They now want to shift that parenting experience to the school. You go to rural India, again, the same problem. There's too many things to do. Mothers say, we can't teach this child anymore. I want my child to go to an English medium school. Interesting fact, government may not agree. In the state of Maharashtra, there were 146 applications for new schools. Only 11 were for Marathi medium schools. 135 were for English medium schools. So everybody in rural India also wants their kids to go to an English medium school, which means they're going to be first generation learners. So the parent can't teach them at home. Going forward, I think the role of the teacher will change. The teacher will not only take on the academic responsibility, but also the emotional and other support for the child in taking on part of the parenting responsibility as well. Let's look at the learner. All this technology and all of this is resulting in the learner having the option to learn on his own, guided, of course, by the teacher. When you look at this, his learning tools become technology-driven. He learns when he wants, how he wants. He learns anytime, anywhere. And the content that he uses is learner-centric. It is no longer teacher-driven. Teachers have to understand that collaborative learning is important. Teachers are now being seen as mentors. More than facilitators, they become mentors. They are more emotional support systems. My panelists have already spoken about the need for research and development. And the key today is concept application. Not just teaching of concept, but application of concept. Teaching of concept is becoming reasonably redundant in today's life. If you don't know how to apply what you learn, you're no longer required by society. They will say, go learn, come back, and we'll give you a job. Curriculum focus is shifting. MHRD is talking about various ways in which to introduce employability skills. And the key thing that is happening, everybody is talking about world is flat. Yes, the world is flat. Awareness of the world around you, awareness, sensitivity to the different cultures, different ways of living, etc., is becoming very, very important. Social skills are becoming very important. And all this, there is no urban or rural divide in all this. This is required in every school for every child in our society. Our schools tend to be one size fits all. There is a school system and the child has to go and fit into the school system. And we have traditionally been driven by 99.98% achievement in science and maths and so on. But now I think the future is going to be about graded proficiency assessment. You don't have to be good at everything. You don't have to score 98%. Based on what, how good you are at different subjects, different topics, you get graded on the basis of your proficiency. And like I said, we will move from school-centric to learner-centric. The role of the school will change. How the school handles children will change. Our schools have traditionally been science, math, and analytical skills based. I got 1 minute left. We will move towards the three C's, which is critical reasoning, creative thinking, and communication. And finally, when we talk about future ready, yes, children will be future ready. In that, we should look at future ready children, not future ready schools. It's critical to look at future ready children. And future ready children are children who know and are comfortable on how to use technology. How do I live in this world? The world is flat. How do I adapt to this world? How do I accommodate change? And how do I accept change? And how do I work as a team member with all people around me? I'm going to leave you with just a couple of thoughts. This is one of my favorites, Howard Gardner. And the key thing about this is thinking scientifically, historically, artistically, ethically, and mathematically. That covers the entire spectrum. And the last point is about something that somebody said about the Industrial Revolution. Kenichi Ohami, probably the greatest strategic thinker, says that no government is happy with what kind of educational system that they have, because our educational system, unfortunately, has its roots in the Industrial Revolution. We now have an information revolution, we have a technology revolution, and therefore we need a different kind of learning environment for today's children. Thank you very much.